An enforcer for a criminal organization named Lorenzo Vitale was seen driving his grandson to an isolated winery on the island of Sicily. As soon as he arrives, he discovers that a significant number of his subordinates have been ruthlessly killed. In the cellar of the winery, he comes face to face with Robert McCall, a former member of the United States Marine Corps and an agent of the DIA who was responsible for the deaths of Lorenzo's bodyguards. Robert confronts Lorenzo about having something that he shouldn't have, and then, after a brief exchange, Robert kills Lorenzo and the remaining of his henchmen. Robert tells Lorenzo's grandson to stay in the car, but the youngster shoots Robert in the back before fleeing. Injured but determined, Robert manages to board a ferry to return to the mainland. Robert's condition worsens that night while traveling around the Amalfi Coast due to the gunshot wound. Gio Benucci, a local carabinier, discovers him unconscious and decides to assist. Gio transports him to Altamonte, an isolated coastal Italian town, where he is treated by a doctor named Enzo. When Robert awakens, he discovers that Gio has saved him and begins his recuperation. Robert explores the town as he begins to regain his strength with the aid of a cane. He eventually winds himself at a small cafe, where he meets Amina, the owner and waitress, who serves him coffee despite his tea request. Gio, who comes to the cafe with his daughter Gabby, hands back Robert's car keys and explains that he parked the car behind the station. Agent Emma Collins answers an anonymous call from Robert to the CIA Financial Operations Group. Before turning off the phone, he discloses critical information concerning the winery's involvement to illegal drug trade activities disguised as regular business transactions. Emma passes this information on to other CIA agents. Robert spends his days getting to know the inhabitants and learning about the Camorra, an Italian mafia gang that extorts money from the town's residents. He observes Angelo, a local seafood vendor, being assaulted by Marco Quaranta, a high-ranking Camorra member who threatens to return for payment the next week. The narrative then turns to Camorra members attempting to forcefully exit a massive structure. The Camorra's head, Marco's brother, Vincent Quaranta, is directing the gang's plot to commercialize the town by building new hotels, resorts, and casinos. An old man in a wheelchair refuses to comply with the Camorra gang in one of the building's rooms. As a result, the gang hangs the old guy from the window and abandons him to die. In the meantime, Robert and Enzo have a great dinner talk, and Robert insists on assisting Enzo with his daily duties. The next morning, he goes to the market on Enzo's behalf and visits Angelo's shop. Angelo graciously refuses to accept payment for the groceries, thinking Enzo's friend's visit to his shop to be an honor. Simultaneously, Emma and other CIA officers arrive at the winery to undertake their investigation based on Robert's information. They discover millions of dollars in cash as well as suitcases full of illegal substances stored in a storeroom. Surprised by these operations that go under their radar, Emma and her colleague, Frank Conroy, decide to investigate further. On a rainy day, Enzo examines Robert's wound, prompting Robert to wonder why Enzo didn't call an ambulance or the police. Enzo responds by recalling Robert's inquiry about being a good or evil person and how he had no solutions. He claims that his quiet at the time was an indication of a nice guy. The next evening, Robert is about to depart town when he is interrupted by the sound of a bell. He watches the crowds heading towards Angelo's shop and decides to join them. It becomes clear that Marco and his crew burned down Angelo's shop due to his inability to pay. Despite their dominance, the locals are powerless to intervene. Robert, along with a few townspeople, assist Angelo in cleaning up the mess. Meanwhile, Gio examines video footage of the firebombing and contacts Italy's central police to inquire about a van seen outside Angelo's shop. As Robert gradually recovers and integrates into the local community, he strengthens his bond with Amina and adjusts to his new surroundings. The Camorra's interference and rising power in Altamonte bother him more than he thought. On an ordinary morning, Robert indulges in his daily dose of coffee at Amina's cozy cafe. As he savors the rich aroma, his keen senses catch Emma, a fellow patron, trying to inconspicuously capture his image with her camera. Robert doesn't miss a beat and approaches her with a friendly smile, suggesting a different, more flattering angle for the photo. Intrigued by his observation, Emma can't help but ask how he became privy to the winery's well-guarded secrets. However, Robert responds with an air of mystery, offering only cryptic hints before encouraging her to focus on her own remaining tasks. As she begins to retreat, she unexpectedly addresses him by name. The surprise on Robert's face is palpable, leaving both of them with questions and a curiosity that lingers in the air. Gio brings up his kid from school later that day. During this time, Gio receives a phone call from an anonymous number notifying him that Gabby's school day ended a little earlier than the rest of the students. Concerned, Gio approaches one of the professors, who informs that an officer had just taken up Gabby. In a panic, he rushes home to find his wife and daughter kidnapped by the Camorra gang. Marco then beats him up in front of his family as a kind of punishment for interfering with their operations. If he interferes again, the gang threatens to kill his family. Robert witnesses Gio leaving Enzo's office with blood streaks on his face in the evening. Curious, he inquires about the occurrence, to which Enzo responds that such incidents are typical in many places due to the Camorra. Enzo compares the situation to cancer with no cure. The next day, Robert goes to church, where he runs across Emma again. She verifies that Lorenzo Vitale was on Interpol's most wanted list for a decade and that his operation was serious. Emma is curious about why he chose her for the anonymous tip and questions his motives. However, he changes the subject by arguing that she should concentrate on why Sicily was chosen for these smuggling operations. Emma promises to get the solution quickly and wants to know the answer to her initial query by their next meeting. Gio and his family are eating supper at a restaurant that evening when Marco and his peers disturb their quality time. Marco requests that Gio assist them in establishing a boat for their private business purposes. Overhearing their chat, Robert, who's also in the restaurant, demands that they leave the family alone. Marco responds by threatening him to stay away from issues that do not concern him. Robert conveys his increasing affection for this place and its people in a calm tone. He then advises Marco to move his business elsewhere and threatens him with dire consequences if he does not. When Marco continues to disregard the warning, Robert twists his shoulder and locks his hand, causing him to scream. He then tells Marco to leave his gun on the table and escape with his guys. After a while, the infuriated Marco intends to return with his goons and murder Robert. But before they can carry out their plan, Robert crashes a van into two of his minions and begins fighting them. At one point, Marco threatens him with a knife and threatens to kill him. In any case, Robert retaliates by twisting Marco's hand and driving the knife through his neck, killing him. The next morning, Frank calls Emma from Rome to inform her of the new station attack. It has been revealed that the cash discovered previously at the winery was also tied to a terrorist act. Emma realizes that the Camorra is directly sponsoring terrorism by paying for cocaine smuggling into Sicily. Furthermore, she believes Naples is a primary transit point for drug trafficking and suspects the presence of another team in Naples. She begins her inquiry by interviewing key Camorra members, determined to unravel the entire chain. She also demands collaboration and access from the head of the Naples police. Later on, the same police chief solemnly gathers at Vincent's opulent mansion to pay his respects at Marco's funeral. Amid the atmosphere of mourning and reflection, he takes a moment to discreetly inform Vincent about the unexpected involvement of CIA officer Emma in their illicit dealings. Vincent, overwhelmed by grief for his slain brother, is consumed by a sudden surge of rage upon hearing this revelation. In an explosive fit of anger, he brutally severs the chief's hand as a harsh warning, his fury mirroring the intensity of the situation. He then issues a menacing ultimatum to the chief, making it abundantly clear that their focus must now shift towards identifying the person responsible for Marco's tragic demise. Following that, Vincent transports the police chief to the hospital, his severed hand preserved in an ice bucket. Emma receives a phone call notifying her of the police chief's problem. Soon after, she receives a call from Robert, who informs her of the Camorra's involvement in the drug cartel, which is directly linked to the previous station attack. Inadvertently, Robert's call saves Emma's life by stopping her from becoming a victim of Vincent's planned explosives attack on her automobile. Emma is brought to the hospital for medical attention as a result of the incident. She meets Frank there and informs him about the Camorra. Frank promises her that he would handle the remaining procedure after understanding everything. That evening, Vincent kidnaps Gio and his family and threatens to shoot them in front of the entire village if his brother's murderer fails to appear. When Vincent doesn't get any information, He shoots Gio in the ear and threatens to kill him with his next shot. Just thereafter, Robert shows himself to Vincent and requests that the captives be released. He claims that he is willing to be taken away and tortured, but not in public. However, Vincent, who is just as arrogant as his brother, refuses, claiming that the people must see the consequences of the action against the Camorras. However, before Vincent can kill him, the townspeople begin filming the event, forcing the gangsters to flee. The same night, Robert breaks into Vincent's house and murders his bodyguards one by one. A trickle of blood on Vincent's forehead awakens him from his dream. The glass just above him shatters, but he manages to escape. He then pulls out his rifle and attempts to contact his deceased gang comrades. Robert visits him shortly after and forces him to swallow a deadly dose of his own drugs. Vincent attempts to flee his mansion, but Robert pursues him. Eventually, the criminal collapses on Naples' cobblestone streets and dies of a heroin overdose. Robert pays a visit to Emma in the hospital the next morning, and she expresses her appreciation for saving her life. He throws money on the floor and tells the story of Greg Dyer, a guy who lost his pension due to a computer attack. This leads her to believe that Robert followed the attack route to the winery, killed Lorenzo and his henchmen, and recovered the precise amount of money owing to Greg. She inquires if Robert and Dyer are friends, to which he responds that they have just met once. Emma embarks on a journey to Boston with the intention of delivering a substantial sum of lifetime earnings to Greg and his wife. Upon receiving this unexpected windfall, Greg can't help but wonder about the identity of the generous benefactor and the motivations behind such a selfless act for a stranger. In response to Greg's curiosity, Emma herself is keen to unravel the mystery behind this act of kindness. As she prepares to leave, Greg eagerly instructs his wife to unpack everything, relieved that they no longer have to make sacrifices that threaten their home. One day at CIA headquarters in Langley, Virginia, Frank hands Emma a parcel containing her mother's diary, leaving her astounded. As Emma delves into its pages, she unravels a surprising revelation. Robert is no stranger but a significant CIA connection to her parents. The citizens of Altamonte are shown celebrating their victory in a football match in the last scene. Robert also takes part in the festivities as a local. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more content like this.